Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvendi. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on solution and discussion on gate question paper in Mechanical Engineering. And this is lecture number 16. We are going to solve the gate question paper on the gas turbine cycle. These are all the books I have published earlier. So, design of transmission system, turbo machines, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering, fluid mechanics and machinery. And also, I have a YouTube channel where I have uploaded the video lectures of all the subjects mentioned here and the solutions for the gate examination question paper. And in the present day situation, the video lectures are very much useful to the students. For repeatedly watching the video, they can learn subject better, they can reinforce their knowledge. So you please subscribe the channel and listen to the videos for your better learning and to pass in the gate examination. And this is the question number, first question from 1995 question paper. So, match the following. So, list A, there are four heat engines, gas turbine, petrol engine, Stirling engine and diesel engine. And list 2, there are different cycles. The explanation, constant volume heat addition and constant volume heat rejection, constant pressure heat rejection and constant volume heat rejection. And third, constant pressure heat addition and constant pressure heat rejection. And fourth one is heat addition at constant volume followed by heat addition at constant temperature, heat rejection at constant volume followed by heat rejection at constant temperature. So, based on our knowledge, so the gas turbine, so the constant pressure heat addition and the constant pressure heat rejection, petrol engine, auto cycle, working on auto cycle, constant volume heat rejection and constant volume heat addition and heat rejection, and the Stirling engine, it is heat addition at constant volume followed by heat addition at constant temperature, and heat rejection at the constant volume followed by heat rejection at the constant temperature. And diesel cycle, the constant pressure heat addition and constant volume heat rejection. So, these are all the matching. And the next question is from 2005 question paper. In two air standard cycles, one operating on auto cycle and another one is operating on Brayton cycle, the air is isentropically compressed from 300 Kelvin to 450 Kelvin. The heat is added to raise the temperature to 600 Kelvin in the auto cycle and 550 Kelvin in the Brayton cycle. So, the eta O, efficiency of the auto cycle and efficiency of beta cycle, or the efficiency of auto and the beta Brayton cycle. So, the eta O equal to 0.25, eta B equal to 0.18, eta O equal to eta B equal to 0.33, and eta O equal to 0.5 and eta B equal to 0.45. It is not possible to calculate the efficiency unless the temperature after expansion is given. So, the answer, efficiency of auto cycle is equal to efficiency of beta cycle, Brayton cycle, for equal to 0.33 for the given temperature conditions. We will see how in the next slide. So, for both auto and Brayton cycle, T1 equal to 300 Kelvin, T2 equal to 450 Kelvin. For auto cycle and Brayton cycle, so eta O equal to 1 minus QR by QS, which is 1 minus T1 by T2. So, simplifying, it is equal to 1 minus T2 by T1, T1 by T2, which is equal to 1 minus 1 by T2 by T1. So, this T2 by T1 equal to R to the power gamma minus 1. So, that is the derivation. But if we take the first second term, 1 minus T1 by T2, so 1 minus 300 by 450 equal to 33.3%. Similarly, for Brayton cycle also, 1 minus QR by QS, which is equal to 1 minus T1 by T2, which is equal to 1 minus 1 by T2 by T1, which is equal to 1 minus 1 by RP to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So, here again, we take the second term, 1 minus T1 minus T2, which is 1 minus 300 by 450 equal to 33.3%. So efficiency equal to 33.3%. Then work done for the cycles. For auto cycle, WO, work done of the auto cycle equal to eta O into CV into T3 minus T2. CV into T3 minus T2 is the heat supply. So 0.333 into 0.718 into 600 minus 450 equal to 35.86 kilowatts. And for a Brayton cycle, work done for the Brayton cycle, that is equal to eta B into CP into T3 minus T2. So that is 0.333 into 1.005 CP into 550 minus 450 equal to 33.46 kilowatts. So therefore, work output of the auto cycle is greater than work output of the Brayton cycle. And in the next question, in continuation to the previous question, if WO and WB are the work output per unit mass, then WO is greater than WB, WO is less than WB, WO is equal to WB, and it is not possible to calculate the work outputs unless the temperature after expansions are given. So we have calculated auto cycle, work done of the auto cycle is greater than work done of the Brayton cycle. The next question from 1999 question paper. An isentropic air turbine is used to supply 0.1 kg of air, 1 kg per second of air at 0.1 meganewton per meter square and 285 Kelvin to a cabin. The pressure at inlet to the turbine is 0.4 meganewton per meter square. Determine the temperature at inlet and the power developed by the turbine. Assume Cp equal to 1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So the given data, M equal to 0.1 kilograms per second, P2 pressure at the outlet of the turbine 0.1 meganewton per meter square, T2 temperature at the outlet of the turbine 285 Kelvin. So the outlet of the turbine is given to the cabin, and the P1, the pressure at the inlet of the turbine 0.1 meganewton per meter square, and Cp equal to 1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. First we have to calculate the temperature at the inlet of the turbine. So for isentropic expansion, T1 by T2 equal to P1 by P2 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So T1 is the temperature at the inlet of the turbine. So T1 equal to T2 into P1 by P2 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is 285 into 0.4 divided by 0.1 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 423.5 Kelvin. And the power developed by the turbine, P equal to MCP into T1 minus T2, which is 0.1 into 1 into 423.5 minus 285 equal to 13.85 kilowatts. So the power developed by the turbine is 13.85 kilowatts. The next question from the 1994 question paper, a gas turbine cycle with infinitely large number of stages during compression and expansion leads to a Stirling cycle, Atkinson cycle, Erickson cycle and Brayton cycle. And we take a gas turbine cycle, which is Brayton cycle, the temperature entropy cycle, temperature entropy diagram of the gas turbine cycle. Now, what is the condition given? Infinitely large number of stages during compression and expansion. So, the compression is 1 to 2 and expansion is 3 to 4. Now, the gas turbine cycle so the pressure, constant pressure heat addition, constant pressure heat rejection. Now the cycle 1 to 2, it is isentropic compression, isentropic compression. Now it is equal to, we are modifying with the more number of, multiple number of stages. So isentropic number of lines of isentropic line and constant temperature, isentropic line and expansion line. Now here there are more number of stages of compression, and here also more number of stages of compression. Now we have the isentropic line and then the pressure, constant pressure line. Now this cycle is modified, actually instead of we have more number of stages, we make it as a constant temperature line and here we draw a constant temperature line. Now this becomes constant temperature process, constant pressure process, constant temperature process, and again constant pressure process, and the cycle is Erickson cycle. So when you have more number of stages of compression and expansion in a Brayton cycle, gas turbine cycle, that leads to Erickson cycle. So the answer is Erickson cycle. And the thermal efficiency of an air standard Brayton cycle in terms of pressure ratio RP and specific heat ratio gamma is given by, we are given four options, A equal to eta equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power RP to the power gamma minus 1, option B 1 minus 1 by RP to the power gamma, option C eta equal to 1 minus 1 by RP to the power 1 by gamma, and option D eta efficiency equal to 1 minus 1 by RP to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So the answer is option D, eta equal to 1 minus 1 by RP to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, where RP is the pressure ratio and gamma is the specific heat ratio, and this is from 2014 question paper. And next question is also from 2014 question paper. For a gas turbine power plant, identify the correct pair of statements. There are four statements given. Smaller in size compared to the steam power plant, starts quickly compared to the steam power plant, works on the principle of Rankine cycle, good compatibility with the solid fuel. So here for gas turbine power plant, first two statements are correct. Smaller in size compared to the steam power plant, overall area occupied and size of the gas turbine plant is very smaller, and it starts quickly because it is starting working on the gas, it starts quickly. First two statements are correct. Third statement, it is totally wrong. Rankine cycle, it is totally wrong. It is working on Brayton cycle. So good compatibility with the solid fuel, it is the gas turbine cycle is not good compatibility with the solid fuel. Solid fuel may also be used, but the answer here is P and Q, they are correct. So P and Q are the correct statement. So the answer is option A, which is PQ. The next question is from 2016 question paper. Consider a simple gas turbine Brayton cycle and the gas turbine cycle with a perfect regeneration. So, ordinary simple Brayton cycle and the gas turbine cycle with the perfect regeneration. In both cycles, the pressure ratio is 6 and the ratio of specific heat of working medium is 1.4, gamma equal to 1.4. The ratio of minimum and the maximum temperature is 0.3 in the regeneration cycle. The ratio of thermal efficiency of simple to that of regenerative cycle is, what is the ratio of efficiency of simple Brayton cycle and regenerative cycle? So the answer is 0.8. So we will see how. So the given data, we are given RP, pressure ratio equal to 6, gamma equal to 1.4, and T minimum by T maximum equal to 0.3. And the Brayton cycle efficiency, we can straight away calculate eta B equal to 1 minus 1 by RP to the power gamma minus 1, which is 1 minus 1 by 6 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 0.4, 40%. And for regenerative cycle, simple regenerative cycle, this is the temperature entropy diagram. And for ideal regeneration, T4 equal to T5, T2 equal to T6. So the outlet temperature of the turbine is equal to T5, outlet temperature of regeneration. So these two temperatures are equal. Now we calculate the efficiency of the regenerative cycle. So this is equal to WT minus WC divided by heat supply. So turbine work is in terms of temperature difference T3 minus T4. Compressor work in terms of temperature difference T2 minus T1. Heat supplied, so T3 minus T5. Now we have perfect intercooling, T4 equal to T5. So the regenerative efficiency, cycle efficiency equal to the numerator as it is, denominator T3 minus T4. So the T5 is replaced by T4. And you look at the numerator and the denominator, first term is very much equal to the denominator. So 1 minus T2 minus T1 divided by T3 minus T4. And this equation will take once again 1 minus. In the numerator, we take T1 outside. So T1 into T2 by T1 minus 1. In the denominator, we take T3 outside. So, T3 into 1 minus T4 by T3. That is equal to 1 minus T1 by T3 into, so numerator T2 minus T1, T2 by T1 equal to Rp to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So, Rp to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma minus 1 divided by, this is 1 minus T4 by T3 equal to 1 by Rp to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So, equal to once again 1 minus T1 by T3 numerator as it is, denominator we take a common denominator, so Rp to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma into to the numerator Rp to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma minus 1. So, finally, this is equal to efficiency of the regenerative cycle equal to 1 minus T1 by T3 into Rp to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So, Rp is the pressure ratio, T1 is the minimum temperature in the cycle and T3 is the maximum temperature in the cycle. Now, we calculate the efficiency of the regenerative cycle, which is 1 minus T1 by T3 into Rp to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is 1 minus 0.3 into 6 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 0.5. And this ratio, efficiency of Brayton cycle, simple Brayton cycle, to the efficiency of regenerative cycle equal to 0.4 divided by 0.5 equal to 0.8. So, that is the answer. So, we have to calculate the ratio of efficiency of Brayton, simple Brayton cycle to the regenerative cycle. The answer is 0.8. The next question is from 1989 question paper. The current level of maximum temperature at a steam turbine inlet is much lower than that of gas turbine inlet because the fuel consumption temperature in the steam generator is lower than that of gas turbine engine. Of the corrosive nature of the high temperature steam on the superheater tubes. The material used for the gas turbine blades are not suitable for the steam turbine blades. Unlike gas turbine blades, the steam turbine blades cannot be cooled. So, in the gas turbine power plant, gas turbine at the entry, the temperature will be above 1500 degrees Celsius. In the case of steam turbine, the temperature will be maximum 600 degrees Celsius. The reason is, the gas turbine blades can be cooled using water circulation. We have water cooled gas turbine blades, whereas in the case of steam turbine, the blades cannot be cooled because in the steam turbine, when the steam is expanding, the quality of the steam decreases. So, when you cool the superheated steam, it becomes wet steam. So, that will affect the overall performance of the gas turbine. So, the correct answer is, unlike gas turbine blades, the steam turbine blades cannot be cooled. That is why the temperature is in the steam turbine is much lower than the gas turbine inlet temperature. The next question is from 1989 question paper. In a gas turbine power plant, intercoolers are used to cool the dash. Hot gases are the compressed air. In order to decrease the dash, expansion work or the compression work. So, the correct answer, compressed air and compression work. So, in gas turbine power plant, the intercoolers are used to cool the compressed air in order to decrease the compression work. The next question is from 1993 question paper. Air expands steadily through a turbine from 6 bar 800 Kelvin to 1 bar 520 Kelvin. During the expansion, the heat transfer from the air to the surrounding at a 300 Kelvin is 10 kilojoules per kg of air. Neglect the change in the kinetic energy and the potential energy and evaluate the irreversibility per kg of the air. Assume air to behave as an ideal gas with the Cp equal to 1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and R equal to 0.3 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Also calculate the actual work and the maximum work per cycle, work done per kg of the air. So, the given data, pressure P3 equal to 6 bar, temperature T3 at the turbine inlet equal to 800 Kelvin, P4 pressure at the turbine outlet equal to 1 bar, temperature actual temperature equal to 520 degree Celsius, 520 Kelvin and the surrounding temperature is 300 Kelvin, the amount of heat loss to the surrounding is 10 kilojoules per kilogram. And Cp equal to 1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and R equal to 0.3 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And this is the temperature entropy diagram, and we calculate the T4. So T4, the temperature at the outlet of the turbine, isentropic expansion. So T3 by Rp to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is equal to 800 divided by 6 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 479.5 Kelvin. So temperature after the isentropic expansion in the turbine. Now irreversibility of the process in the entire turbine, I equal to TO into delta S of the system plus delta S of the surrounding. So delta S of the system equal to TO into Cp into logarithmic of T4 by T3 minus R into logarithmic of P4 by P3 plus delta S of the surrounding equal to, there is heat transfer Q divided by TO. So Q divided by TO, that is the heat transfer. Okay, now TO equal to 300 into 1 into Cp equal to 1 into logarithmic of T4 equal to 520 divided by 800 minus R equal to 0.3 and the logarithmic of P4 by P3 1 by 6 plus 10 divided by 300. So calculating the irreversibility equal to 42.02 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now the maximum work equal to Cp into T3 minus T4, which is equal to 1 into 800 minus 479.5 equal to 320.5 kilojoules per kilogram, and the actual work equal to Cp into T3 minus T4 dash, which is 1 into 800 minus 520 equal to 280 kilojoules per kilogram. The next question from 1993 question paper, in a gas turbine cycle with the heat exchange and reheating improves only thermal efficiency, only the specific power output, both thermal efficiency and the specific power output, neither the thermal efficiency nor the specific power output. So here we have the heat exchange, that is regeneration and reheating. So regeneration, it is using the exhaust gases or the waste gases, the heat is supplied to the air is heated, that is what regeneration. And reheating, in the higher capacity power generation, we take two stages of expansion, high pressure turbine and low pressure turbine, in between we are using the reheating. So reheating is used to increase the work output of the turbine or net work output of the cycle, and regeneration is used for decreasing amount of fuel supply, so thereby increasing the thermal efficiency. So the effect of these two, regeneration and reheating, is both the thermal efficiency and the specific power output, they are increasing or improving. The next question from 1999 question paper, select the statement from list 2 matching the process in the list 1. Enter your answer as A comma B if the correct choice is 1 is A and 2 is 4. So we have the two process, intercooling and isothermal compression, and list 2, A, no heat transfer during compression, B, reduces low temperature compression work, C, heat rejection during compression, and D, reduces high pressure compression work. So first intercooling is used between the low pressure compressor and the high pressure compressor. The intercooling reduces the high pressure compression work, so 1D. Second, isothermal compression is constant temperature, so the compression, it is heat rejection, so the answer is 1D2C, so heat rejection during compression, that is what isothermal compression. The next question is from 2003 question paper, in a gas turbine, hot combustion product with the specific heats of Cp equal to 0.98 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and Cv equal to 0.7538 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin enters a turbine at 20 bar 1500 Kelvin and exit at 1 bar. The isentropic efficiency of the turbine is 0.94. So the work developed by the turbine per kg of the gas flow is 689.64 kilojoules per kilogram, 794.66 kilojoules per kilogram, 1009.72 kilojoules per kilogram and 1312 kilojoules per kilogram. So the correct answer is 689.64 kilojoules per kilogram. So, we will see how in the next slide. So, the given data Cp equal to 0.98 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, Cv equal to 0.7538 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, pressure at the entry of the turbine P3 equal to 20 bar, T3 temperature at the entry of the turbine 1500 Kelvin. So, P4 at the temperature at the outlet of the turbine is 1 bar and efficiency of the turbine is 0.94. So, the specific heat ratio Cp gamma equal to Cp by Cv equal to 0.98 divided by 0.7538 equal to 1.3. Now, work output of the turbine. So, the actual work output of the turbine equal to Cp into T3 minus T4A, which is equal to eta T into Cp into T3 minus T4S. So, the isentropic work into turbine efficiency equal to actual work. So, we have the eta T, actually, so you take eta T Cp into T3 into 1 minus T4 by Ts, which is eta T Cp into T3 is 1 minus 1 by Rp to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So, substituting turbine efficiency equal to 0.94, Cp equal to 0.98, T3 equal to 1500 Kelvin and 1 minus 1 by 20 to the power 1.3 minus 1 divided by 1.3 equal to 689.64 kilojoules per kilogram. That is what the work output of the turbine. And the next question from 2004 question paper, the pressure ratio of a gas power plant cycle corresponding to maximum work output for a given temperature limit of T minimum and T maximum will be. So, the pressure ratio of the gas turbine power plant for maximum work output. So, Rp maximum equal to, there are four options given, T maximum by T minimum to the power gamma by 2 into gamma minus 1, option B, T minimum by T maximum to the power 2 by gamma by 2 into gamma minus 1, option C, T maximum by T minimum to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, and option D, T minimum by T maximum to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So, the correct answer is option A. So, optimum pressure ratio or maximum pressure ratio equal to T maximum by T minimum to the power gamma by 2 gamma minus 1. The next question is from 2011 question paper. An ideal Barayton cycle operating between the pressure limits of 1 bar and 6 bar has a minimum and maximum temperature of 300 Kelvin and 1500 Kelvin. The ratio of specific heats of the working fluid is 1.4. The approximate final temperature in Kelvin at the end of the compression and expansion respectively. The answer is, so T2 is the temperature at the end of the compression. So, T1 into Rp to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is 300 into 6 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 500. And the T4 is the temperature at the end of the expansion. So, T4 equal to T3 by Rp to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is 1500 divided by 6 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 900 Kelvin. So, option A is the correct answer. And next question from 2013 question paper. So, in a simple Barayton cycle, the pressure ratio is 8. And the temperature at the entrance of the compressor and turbine are 300 Kelvin and 1400 Kelvin respectively. Both the compressor and the gas turbine have isentropic efficiency equal to 0.8. For a gas, assume a constant value of Cp equal to 1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and ratio of specific heat equal to 1.4. Neglect the change in the kinetic energy and the potential energy. So, there are two questions in the statement. First question, the power required by the compressor in kilojoules per kilogram of the gas, kg of flow rate is, the answer is 304.3 kilojoules per kilogram and we will see how in the next slide. So, the compressor work is equal to, actual compressor work equal to Cp into T2 minus T1 divided by efficiency of the compressor. So, that is equal to Cp into T1 into T2 by T1 minus 1. So, divided by eta C. So, Cp into T1 into Rp to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma minus 1 divided by compressor efficiency. So, substitute in numerical values 1 into 300 into 8 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 minus 1 divided by 0.8 is equal to 304.3 kilojoules per kilogram. So, that is what the option we have taken here. 304.3 kilojoules per kilogram, that is what the compressor power required. Next question from the same statement, in continuation to the previous problem, the thermal efficiency of the cycle is in percentage is 24.8%, 38.6%, 44.8% and 53.1%. The correct answer is 24.8%. So, we will see how in the next slide. So, we calculate from the compressor work Cp into T2 dash minus T1 equal to 304.3. So, T2 dash equal to the temperature, actual temperature at the outlet of the compressor, T2 dash equal to 304.3 plus 300 because Cp equal to 1. So, which is 604.3 Kelvin. And for the turbine, T4 equal to temperature, actual temperature, sorry, isentropic temperature at the outlet of the turbine, T4 equal to T3 by Rp to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is 1400 divided by A to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 772.86 Kelvin. And the actual temperature with reference to the turbine efficiency, so T4 dash equal to T3 minus turbine efficiency into T3 minus T4, which is 1400 into 0.8 minus 0.8 into 1400 minus 772.86 equal to 898.29 Kelvin. Now, we calculate the turbine work, Wt equal to Cp into T3 minus T4 dash, which is 1 into 1400 minus 898.29, which is 501.71 kilojoules per kilogram, and the heat supplied equal to Cp into T3 minus T2 dash, which is equal to 1 into 1400 minus 604.3 equal to 795.7 kilojoules per kilogram, and substituting in the eta, efficiency of the cycle, Wt minus Wc divided by heat supplied, which is equal to 501.71 minus 304.3, the turbine compressor work, divided by heat supplied 795.7 equal to 0.248, which is 24.8%. That is what the answer we have selected in the previous slide. So, the efficiency is 24.8%. So, we stop here. So, thank you for watching. And you please post your comments on the YouTube comments box if there is any comments, and you subscribe the channel, YouTube channel, so that you will get the updated videos, and you can contact me for any clarification or queries through my mail ID or WhatsApp number. I will answer to your queries. So, thank you for watching. We will meet you in the next slide, next video with additional problems from the GATE question paper on the gas turbine cycle. Thank you.